Saltyhead here, all set for another trip. This one will be up to the Kancamagus Highway up in New Hampshire, up in the White Mountain National Forest. We're going to be taking up my new mobile camper, and we're going to give it the old test to see how it performs. So please join me in this wonderful new trip, and it should be a great adventure. The weather looks great, and so come on along and enjoy the fun. Just got around Boston. We had to go on the 128, the old 128, around the city because of the propane on board. I guess you're not allowed to go through the tunnels in case something accidentally ignites, takes down the tunnel. It's quite expensive to rebuild those things, as we know, with the big dig. So we're headed north and we're going to New Hampshire. It's the sun came out. Looks pretty nice up ahead. I see restless longing for some solitary company. I know that I must do what's right. Sure as Kilimanjaro rises. Oh, welcome to the great state of New Hampshire, the land of the free, the granite state, the ninth state. There's a wood pile. Look at that. That's a big wood pile. It is cold this morning, let me tell you. Must be in the 30s. It's really calm. But it's nice to be up in the woods. So this morning, I would just like to give you a little tour of my little home here in the woods, the Alpine Mobile Cabin. So as we come, well, actually outside here we have a little grill, it's a gas grill, a little table, and as we come inside here, you can see that we got a little bed over here on the right. A little full-size bed with a refrigerator. And I've added a 6-inch cushy foam mat, which gives it a little extra warmth and comfort. And then up here we have the kitchen, which has a 3-burner stove, of course my coffee maker, sink, hot and cold water, a nice little view out into the woods. And we have this hanging linen closet. And over here we have the queen size bed. And here we have a little, we have microwave for the dolly, electronics like the air conditioning and the heat, stereo. And so it's a little small, but it's just what the doctor ordered. So back here I have my two Honda generators, which is enough power to take care of everything. I linked them up because one wasn't enough. I needed at least 3,000 watts. So that should do it. Over here we have the Sky Ranger. This isn't hooked up yet because I don't know how to do it, but I'll figure it out. That's to get linked in with the Wi-Fi that doesn't exist in the woods. So I don't know what's gonna happen there, but we'll probably have to drive to town. And then I've got my kayak here. That's for later in the day, a little entertainment. And then we come around here. And this is my outdoor shower. So I just kinda, you know, wash up. I'll be doing that shortly because I haven't really got that fire yet, the morning routine. And then, you know, it's pretty simple. So, you might ask, what's for breakfast? Well, this morning it's not gonna be a traditional breakfast because I didn't have dinner last night. I'm gonna have dinner for breakfast. Sounds a little confusing, but you haven't been with me long enough. So this morning we're gonna have cream of mushroom soup with chicken a la grilled. So it should be tasty. Well, you might ask, why do I like sleeping in the woods, being attacked by mosquitoes and mayflies, getting wet in the rain? Well, let me show you why. What do you, you guys think I'm ready for class five yet? Huh? Think I can do it? I don't know, I better strap up my life preserver though, right? Just doing a little short hike. It's called the Boulder Loop Trail. It's off the Kancamagus at the Covered Bridge Campground. It's about a 3-mile hike. It's a good way to start your day. So one of the things I wanted to talk about was the sense of smell. You know, when we go out to dinner, you know, we smell the garlic, we smell all the spices and herbs, but it's a little different out here in the wilderness. And I love the smell out here. It's all earthy and, you know, the leaves from last fall, you can smell them. They're still decaying and they give off like a nutty smell. And, you know, sometimes we take these things for granted, but I think as you get older, you can, the sense of smell and others, the taste, it tends to go away or become less pronounced. And so I really try to absorb the smell. You know, I can smell the green, I really can. Plus I'm probably inhaling a ton of pollen, but the other thing is when you get up above 3,000 feet, you get into the alpine zone, which is my favorite zone, because I love the smell of balsam. You know, it gives me that's Christmas tree smell, and to me, there's nothing like it. I mean, I have a pillow at home that is stuffed with balsam, and I keep it right by my face all night. And so, it makes me feel like I'm back in the alpine zone. And so, anyways, that's just a little dissertation on the sense of smell. You know, it's just important. They're all important. You want to keep it all. So up and away we go. Here we are at the top. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. It's been a wonderful time up here in New Hampshire at the Kancamagus Highway. The old Alpine mobile cabin worked out great. Every part of it has just been a dream come true. And now I have to go back home and clean up the gear and start planning my next trip. I'm not sure where that'll be, but it should be a lot of fun. And I hope you join me. If you like the video, give it the thumbs up. And I look forward to seeing you on my next trip. And if you do make it up here to the Kancamagus, don't forget your bathing suit. The water's a little bit cold, but it is so invigorating. You'll love it.